a bite. I think I got a bite.
Got a lot of stress on my mind. It's a nice day to go. Yeah, I got a line. I'ma call up the whole team.
Hey, show her that he's hooked up. Hold on, look, he's hooked up.
Hey, what's up, guys? This is Team Hard Life Captain Albert Sarducci. And you see my kids, they are rocking and rolling. Definitely not giving these drums any slack over here. They are putting into it. Putting in some back-breaking work over here. And, yeah, you know, the girls are definitely catching their personal best. Mr. Jaron right here, though, he's got some big shoes to fill because he's already set his personal best at 46 inches. Which he did back-to-back on the same night last year. So he's definitely on the lookout for his next big one. We'll see what he can end up doing, because as you saw in the last video, he did a double hookup. And right when we got the camera on the water is when the first one came off. And that one was a beast, but we were able to land the second one, which is great. And we'll keep it rocking. Now it's a double hookup with me and him. One of the biggest things I want to give a shout out to is all the guys that were around me and Gary and fishing on the pier with us, as we all work together to help each other land each other's fish and clear the way as we were fishing and laying down rods or unhooking fish. Everybody was just teamwork. It didn't matter how many you were on or how many you were ahead or you hadn't caught anything. Everybody was putting in work to help us land fish, and we helped them. And talk about awesome. It didn't matter. Like I said, it shouldn't matter where you're from, what you're fishing with, how many you got. It's, hey, help that guy land his fish, help his kids land his fish, or let me help you. And it was awesome. And look at that monster. That's so awesome. Wow. Proud dad moment right there for sure. Thank you.
the net right there and he wouldn't go in. Thank you.
talk about some exhausting work right here, guys. It's been a super long time since I fished with more than 3 rods during any kind of tournament. Plus, you know, like I said, it's something that you got to get be used to for sure, and to put in the work, and then, you know, definitely keep the kids rocking and rolling because they got the energy. And Miss Kiki over here was wanting to win big time. I offered up a couple of small little challenges between the kids. First one would get $5 for the first drum to be caught. Second one was a $20 pot to catch the biggest fish. And then the third $20 pot was to catch the most fish. So Kiki was rocking and rolling over here. She gets into her game face on, and she is not willing to back down at any level. So this was pretty awesome. So she was definitely keeping me on my toes, and I was willing to go forth for it. So let's see how she does toward the end of the trip.
Thank you.
Alright. Well, that one's going on.
By this time, all three of them were sitting there being real competitive, trying to be the first person to get on the rod. With three rods to choose from, they knew it was still first come, first serve. So they had to be attention to the rods going off for them. And then I had my three for the tournament, so I was still trying to do what I needed to do to get my entry in. Since my 39 and a quarter inch had gotten beaten down, there is now a 42 inch. I believe it was 42 and a half inch that's in the lead. So we'll keep it rocking and rolling, guys. Thank you very much.